Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to my channel. And today we have a slightly special one to test on the open road. And it is the special window bracket, window mount for DSLR cameras, as well as the GoPros or any other camera for that matter. After the long research that I've been doing for the past few days and going throughout the internet and trying to find anything that would be suitable for positioning the camera in the right with the right angle and also to give it enough rigidity and also not to be scared that it would fall off on any uneven road or any rough road, wasn't that easy, to be honest. And most of the times I was coming across the devices that was far too complicated, far too heavy. In some cases I've seen the devices that are even sandwiching the glass between two magnet slats. So all of those was a bit too much for my liking. However, I've come across very, very simple system to use and a nice attachment to use. Would like to present you this Fantaseal. I've got a box in front of me. Fantaseal, two suction cups attached to the windscreen with the good mechanism, which I have to say is done really with a great quality. Then you position any DSLR camera for that matter. In the meantime, I also have to state that past my videos were not so much of the great quality, especially having no microphone. And not having a microphone, first of all, and not having a proper camera did reflect quite a bit on the quality of my videos. However, I am so pleased to announce also another addition to my camera collection, which I have now by Sony ZV-1. It's been a lot of tutorials, a lot of reviews on the internet, how great it is, how much functionality such a little camera packs into it. And for me, as a sort of a beginner in a way, and also for the guy who doesn't need to adjust the cameras to the manual settings as such, I'm happy if it's on intelligent setting and it sort of figures out those settings by itself. So this video will be proudly recorded on the Sony ZV-1 and proudly transmitted with the microphone by Rode. You probably can see me in that extended screen how properly this also is installed on the window, and I will give you a close-up image. Also, the angle is quite right for my liking. To be honest with you, I am so keen to go out on different types of the roads and test it, how it is performing on all sorts of roads that I can go with this car. Oh, going back to the watching some tutorials, how other my colleagues have been going through and reviewing this particular device, I thought maybe it is lacking for some proper build qualities, or maybe it's lacking some strength to it. But let me assure you, it is done to perfection. At least it does serve my need quite perfectly. I would like to hit the open road now and demonstrate how does it perform, and I'm more than sure that this will not fall off the window, and it is gonna serve its perfect purpose quite well. So here we've come on the little town roads to give it a bit of a test. You get all sorts of road surfaces here. You get a bit of a wiggliness in a bit of potholes as well, and you do kind of put like that this device into the bit of a test. It was a lot of thinking for me in the beginning. First, I thought maybe GoPro just does the job for me. I went for lots of accessories for GoPro. I went for wide lens mode and the media mode and all of those accessories for it. But of course, it will never now I understand that it will never take that sort of a picture quality. I'm still in love with the little GoPro, to be honest. It is still quite a little camera that you can hop into your pocket. However, this Sony is actually ticking all the boxes for me, for the simple fact it fits in your pocket. It has this lovely handle which actually works as a remote. Actually, I'm filming now using this quite a lot. And once you have all this sort of first equipment that you're good to go for vlogging or taking videos of the content that you like, then you are sitting and thinking, what is exactly that holder that you would use to fix this camera in the place? And the market is frankly quite flooded with all sorts of suction cups that you could use, but it did not convince me enough. I've looked at almost probably all of them, but it didn't convince me enough that any of those that I've seen are good enough for this job. However, this Fantaseal, I've picked up on a couple of the really nice reviews on the YouTube that guys are really saying the good things about this holder. So I thought maybe I just give it a try, and oh boy, the happy I am with this holder. So yeah, I think in the beginning, especially since today is the 26th of February, and the first video I've uploaded on YouTube was the 8th of February. For this short while, for me to get my head around all the equipment that one might need for at least somewhere with a nice quality and somewhere with a nice sound vlogging equipment, I think I've come up with not a bad equipment, and Sony for sure does that job perfectly for me. Okay, so we've released ourselves from that dreadful queue, and now we are going on this little nibbly and twisty roads, and I am, as I said, very confident that this holder will do its job really perfectly. The minute it arrived this morning, I looked at the box and I saw what I believe is Ferrari. What, California is on the packaging. I know that's mostly serving the advertising purposes, and yes, all the car accessory manufacturing companies are sort of going out there and grabbing the beautiful cars to put on the front page, but not the front page, to put on the box that it's about. The minute I saw that Ferrari on there, I thought, that's it. That's gonna be the right thing for my car, because again, I did mention in my past videos quite a few times, because of the way these cars ride and slightly bit rougher on the rougher side they are, you know, because of they are, you know, they will never turn into your limousines, and they will always sort of be in that kind of a sports car territory, if you'd like. So many people these days, they are turning their cars into little mobile offices and then hop their cameras into on the windscreen and do lots of exciting videos. I personally admire a lot myself to watch those guys. Sometimes they're filming the road, sometimes they talk about the useful stuff, they give you a really good tutorials while they're driving, and I find that quite appealing. So far so good. I see myself perfectly. The colors shown on this camera are just tremendous. I am so in love with this. Yes, of course I could go for much more expensive older brothers like I had to twist my head to see upcoming traffic. I could go for the expensive older brothers like A64, 6600, or Canon for that matter, what, M50. They have a great stabilization, ginormous removable lens to it, but for a guy like me, for the purpose that I'm using these cameras for, I think Sony does this job so well, and I'm so grateful that I've chosen this exact camera for that job. So yeah, we've come down to on a little bit of a dual carriageway stretch, probably like 4 or 5 miles of a driving distance. And if I were to give the points to this holder together with the camera, I think I'm so excited at the moment, I would give it all the points that I had at my disposal. But yes, this is a great set. This is a great choice for sure. It does a fantastic job, and it will be a lot of driving and more videos while I'm driving, of course, but also while I'm doing some further exciting stuff will be filmed on these beautiful cameras, on this lovely set, and will be presented to you guys. So yes, to sum up all my sort of impressions about this set, yes, nobody out there taught me, go here on this website, buy this device. This knowledge, if I can call this a knowledge, has come to me fully by my personal research. Yes, I'm quite a pedantic person to the degree that I like to investigate as much as I can investigate about the product before I hit the buy button on internet, because that's what happens these days. You can't physically go to the shops and buy anything in the real life. Everything, all our life has shifted to the internet world. We're all well aware of this. So yeah, a lot of research going into this, a lot of late nights sitting in front of my iPad and doing lots of going through YouTube tutorials and finding out what all the people think about the device that you want to purchase. And very importantly to also mention, I have now recently come across this very, very awesome iPad software called LumaFusion, which is quite an innovation for me. I will be educating myself as I move forward, but I'm very excited also that this exact video I would love to edit on LumaFusion on my iPad. I've always been into my iMacs. I don't know why. I have always liked the presentation, the look of iMacs, the fact that it's a stationary. And I thought the mobile work that I have to do one way or another, I could possibly move on to iPad. And then as at the beginning of all this sort of video editing business, I thought, what if I cannot use my iPad for the proper purpose? What if I'm on the go and sometimes I need to do these editings and it just doesn't work the way I want it to work? So, but not. LumaFusion has sorted that problem for me. Gosh, it is so cheap. £30 for that application is absolutely nothing when the nearest competitors to LumaFusion are hundreds of pounds, probably. For that matter, I don't know if any Final Cut Pro is available for iPad. For Mac, it costs in the neighborhood of £200 to £300 to purchase that application, when there's some of them, they are on a monthly fee. So yes, combination of LumaFusion on my iPad, combination of that holder and the Sony ZV-1 makes this this job perfectly possible for me, and I'm very excited. I think I will wrap up on this one, guys. I think I have expressed my utter excitement. I have expressed how pleased I am with sort of concluding with all the parts that I needed for my filmmaking. And I'll meet you in the next one, possibly showing you some more exciting stuff that touches the basis of, say, some design pieces, because I am myself a lot into a design field, in particular lighting design. I do look after a few lighting design lighting firms. So I'll be going around town, country, possibly the world, and covering all the beautiful showrooms, with coming across the possibly vintage one-off pieces, maybe some art, maybe some pieces of beautiful furniture that is also in the limited production, all that sort of stuff, which is quite a lot of passion of mine. But predominantly, I'll be doing that, as long as it's within this country, with this car. So stay tuned, and I'll see you in the next one.